What was that?
I said I don't trust you.
Why? Where are we?
We're at a hotel.
How are you guys? Alex, nice to meet you, man.
Alex, nice to meet you.
Alana,
nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Cool. You ready?
Sure.
All right.
She has no idea what's going on.
She has
on.
No idea?
Yeah.
All right. He wanted to surprise you with a chiropractic adjustment to help you.
So. I'm going to cry. You need to stop. We've got an emotional day.
I told you.
Yeah, she's going to cry. So this is going to be great. I mean, I heard you're in a lot of pain and everything. Today was kind of rough and I heard your story. So, you know, I want to talk and just, you know, see what's going on.
I'm going to give you a hug.
But I mean, he wanted to do it, so I can't say no to something like that.
Yeah. I love you, but also I can't say no.
I got you.
It's just gonna be kind of tough because we gotta figure out like where to do it and figure it out. All right?
Thanks.
Yeah, come on, let's do it.
Oh, that one hurt.
Oh, God.
Bless America.
Because I know Hanan was telling me a little bit about why he wanted to do it, so I want to hear your story, I want to hear what happened, I want to hear, like, you know, just your story just in general.
Yeah, so, I mean, I guess the big story is that I've lost, like, 256 pounds.
Holy cow.
I had gastric sleeve surgery in 2017. Hmm. I had battled with weight since I was a kid and could never lose the weight. I was diagnosed with PCOS and diabetes at 15, so they put me on a whole bunch of medication and it just skyrocketed.
It's kind of messy up also, like, other ways too.
Yeah.
That medication, yeah.
Mm-hmm. And, like, I put on so much weight whenever they started putting me on that medication. Mm-hmm. And when I was away in college, I got really, really sick and they found a tumor on my stomach. Thank the Lord, it was benign, but it was definitely a reality check for myself. The doctor was like, if you don't lose weight, you're gonna die by 25.
How did that make you feel?
I didn't take it seriously at first.
Really?
Yeah, I was more of like, what? I'm invincible, I was 19. And I kind of spiraled for another 6 months after that, put on another 50 pounds, and my highest weight was 415.
415?
Mm-hmm.
Do you mind what I ask, what do you weigh now?
Yeah, so I weigh about 148.
That's so awesome.
It's kind of crazy. Honestly.
What made you, like, what was the thing that made you like I got to do it now? Like, this is...
So I had struggled with mental health a lot. Mm-hmm. And there were several times in my life where I wanted to take my own life.
Wow.
And I was in the middle of an attempt and a really good friend of mine called me and we just had a really long conversation. And he was telling me how much I impacted him and how much I made him want to be alive.
You're gonna make me cry. That's crazy.
I'm surprised I'm not crying.
Yeah.
Honestly. But I just remember that conversation and I got sick again and I just had to face the music of like, hey, like if this hasn't worked the three times that I've tried, like I've meant to be here for a reason.
Yeah.
And I tried losing weight some more like naturally and then eventually my doctor was like, hey, like this is the gastric sleeve. Mm-hmm. I understand that you're kind of against it, but let's have a conversation. And I was able to have it in like 2 or 3 months.
Wow. That's awesome. Now, I know a lot of people, I think one of the things that people now are becoming so much more aware of is mental health stuff.
Mm-hmm.
What challenges, and I know I'm asking you to like
no,
get some
you're good.
Cords and stuff, you're but good. I think this is great because when people watch this, I think what is different and what I'm trying to do differently is really tap into mm-hmm. more relatable things in the sense of not just getting pain, but like just stories in general,
yeah.
Right? Because I think everyone has a story. I think everybody has a purpose. And I think you trying to take your own life three times and not happening, I think, you know, there's a sign from God saying like, yo, there's something.
Yeah, there's something bigger.
There's something bigger,
yeah.
Right? And if my channel can help that to anybody that's watching, I mean, that's the whole purpose of it.
Yeah.
So what kind of mental stuff were you like?
I went through this phase in life where I was bullied, but I didn't want to believe I was bullied.
Mm.
I was like the butt of the jokes. And so I would make jokes too, to make it like soften the blow.
Yeah.
And then eventually I started doing my own inner work and I was like, man, I was bullied. Like I was excluded. People talked a lot of trash about me. I lost a lot of friends. I got asked out on like pity dates.
Oh,
it was, yeah. And it affected me in a way that I don't think I realized until recently, because I was always the funny fat friend. Like I was just like, oh, like a fun time to be around, but no one wanted to invite me out. And so I struggled a lot internally, not thinking that I was enough for anybody else. Because I would constantly try to form myself into who other people wanted me to be, and then I would be sad when I wasn't that person, and they didn't like that person. And so I created a lot of expectations around who I was quote unquote meant to be, and I let that dictate a lot of my decisions growing up. When I wasn't happy with what was looking back at me, I would internalize even more and be like, wow, like I don't even know who I am.
Yeah.
And my family life wasn't the best. My parents are loving and they did everything they could with what they had, but it wasn't exactly an environment where I could openly express those things.
Sure, yeah.
And I just ended up not feeling like I was enough.
What changed?
Honestly, beyond built.
No, that's all. Yeah. I'm gonna start working on you while we're talking.
Yeah, you're good. So I joined a group 3 years after losing like the majority of my weight. I had gained 50 pounds back. Chad Morgan slid into my DMs and was like, hey, I like your story.
Yeah,
follow Chad Morgan
Fit, by the way.
Follow Chad Morgan
Fit. Yeah.
But yeah, so he messaged me and I started doing like inner work. I was working with Farshad. We started going through a lot of my traumas and things that just affected me in ways. Yep. And I am still learning how to appreciate who I am as a person and like the things that have made me who I am, including like the bad parts.
I think, yeah, internalizing what, even, so I'm 33 now, right? And I have some relations to like what you're talking about. You know, as growing up in high school, and this is not really meant to be a race thing, but I grew up in Pittsburgh and most of those people were all white, right? I had like, I was in the 600 class, I was only the token Asian kid. And you got the butt of the Asian jokes all the time. I even remember like when I was dating one of my first girlfriends, her cousin was like, why are you dating that Asian person, right? It's like, why are you dating him? Or you're, you know, you're good looking for an Asian person or something, like some weird like stuff that you don't really think or like hold any value to. You're like, oh yeah, cute for an Asian, like, and you actually think that you're proud of it, and it's like, that's not really, it's not really right, you know?
Yeah.
Because we're all people, no matter like what your size is, no matter what you look like, no matter whoever it is, right? Yeah. We all deserve to be treated as a human, no matter what it is.
Yeah, right? And I relate to that in a sense too. So I've recently started talking more about this, but I'm completely deaf in my left ear. And so for a long time I was bullied for it, and I always felt like I had to address my disability to everybody else to make them feel comfortable.
Yeah.
And like I'm understanding now that like that's not the case, but for a long time I always thought that I had to make other people feel better.
Sure, right.
And so like I remember being like the token like deaf joke and like people making fun of it, and I was like, oh, that's funny. And then I'm like, wow, that hurts.
It's like, that's not really that funny.
Yeah.
You know, one of the things that I do notice with people that are coming from a heavier weight to smaller weight, right, is that your spine and your body kind of tends to hold on to how you were before, right? So your posture, your body, your aches, your pains, it's almost like it's still the same, but you're like in a different body, like what's going on?
Yeah.
So your body holds in a lot of stress, holds in a lot of trauma, holds in a lot of those types of things. So physically, where I'm getting with this is, what's hurting you today?
So I should tell you, I have an extra vertebrae in my back.
Okay.
It's like an extra tailbone.
Yeah, okay.
And so my left hip naturally sits higher than my right hip. So okay. I always have lower back pain, and then I carry my stress in my shoulders and in, like the bottom parts of my trap.
Okay. So down in here, up and through here, and then down and through here. And you said which hip was?
My left hip.
Your left hip was higher?
It sits higher.
It sits higher. Gotcha. Yeah, I mean, you got a lot of things going on.
It also doesn't help that I carried around so much weight for so long too, so.
Yeah, you probably have a lot of compression, a lot of things. And I'll be honest with you, right after this first, have you gotten adjusted before?
Yeah, so I was actually getting adjusted regularly, and then I moved away and wasn't able to see a chiropractor for a while. So it's been about 2 years that I've gotten adjusted.
How did you feel whenever you were getting?
I felt great.
Okay.
Yeah, cool. It was, his name is Dr. Kubeka. He's the nicest person ever.
Nice.
He was just this big old dude, and he would just grab me and just pop me. I was like, okay.
He was like, yeah, I'm just gonna do
it. Yeah, he's like, well, I'm gonna bear hug you and you're gonna feel better. Yeah. I was like, okay.
I really appreciate you sharing your story. This is totally something that is different that we do. Normally it's a lot of just, you know, what's your problem? Let's do this, let's do that. And the biggest thing for me is purpose, right? Just, I think you have a purpose. I think everyone has a purpose. And I think when we're given things, there's a lot more responsibility to it. Right, not just monetarily, because money, you can get money, whatever, it doesn't matter. But it's about impacting people, changing people's lives, seeing what the difference is between, and really just relating, right? Because there's a lot of people that are watching that will comment and they'll be like, yeah, because I think the last video that I posted, there was a heavyset guy. The heavyset guy, people were so appreciative of it because they were like, you know, all these people that you see on on YouTube, they're like all in yoga pants and mm-hmm. models and stuff like that. And you know, they're like, oh, I'm so happy I was able to see this. And I was thinking, you know, if that person can relate just to size, mm-hmm. mentally, physically, like other things, they can absolutely. And I'm sure your story is not the same one, right? Like other people have similar stories, mm-hmm. right? But I think it can absolutely impact and touch people and help people in ways that we could never imagine just because of a camera.
Yeah, right. And I want to like say thank you for like wanting to tell these stories,
because
I recently started my own passion project where I get to tell stories of other people who impact me and I have the honor of getting to know. Mm-hmm. And there's so much power in stories. And
there is, absolutely.
Even though like someone may feel like they're not important or mm-hmm. their story doesn't matter, like it's going to impact someone, just as long as you believe it.
No, absolutely. So, I think you're absolutely right. So you feel like this thing right over here. Mm-hmm. So I'm gonna press right in through here first.
Okay.
And what you're gonna do is you're gonna take your arm and then you're gonna bring it all the way up. You're gonna count
out
all
and
the way
up,
up
or
to five.
Just right.
Just straight.
Okay.
And then you're gonna bring it all the way up, just like this. And then you're gonna bring it behind your back, just like this. And then you're gonna look to the, like 45.
Okay.
And then you're gonna look down. What I want to do is just really release this area. All right. So one of the things that I want to ask you is like, what you in the position that you are in now. Mm-hmm. What would you tell yourself previously when you were at that weight going through all that stuff?
You matter. That's the biggest thing. I went for so long in my life, like I just always thought that I didn't matter and I always thought that I wasn't enough. And if I could go back and tell 19-year-old Alana, like you're enough.
That's powerful. That's very powerful. Does that hurt a little bit when you do that?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Look straight again. Just keep doing that, bring that up. Yeah, that whole point of you matter, it's that self-worth, it's that confidence issue of thinking like, man, I actually mean something in this world and that you don't want to be forgotten by anybody else. And I think once you align yourself and you truly are very physically and mentally realistic with who you are and you forget all the noise that other people have said,
mm-hmm.
I think it's a huge and powerful thing to really know who you are. Are you doing okay?
Yeah, I'm
good. Look straight again. Bring us up. Is that getting easier?
A little bit, yes, sir.
Oh, don't call me sir.
I'm from Texas. It's literally embedded into my system.
It makes me feel old.
My mom would be upset if she found out that I was not saying sir.
So how old are you now?
I'm 24.
You're 24. Wow. Mm-hmm. So what is your goal, your purpose in life now?
Just to inspire people to understand their...
Bring it back up. Yeah,
just to understand their worth and feel the power that they have in themselves, because I never felt it growing up. And if I can help one person do that, then I know I'm doing what I'm supposed to do.
And that's the thing about purpose. It's all about serving others.
Mm-hmm. I guess I should also tell you that I had complete reconstructive surgery on my left shoulder.
Okay.
That might be why the left side's harder.
Look straight. Bring this back up. What happened to your shoulder?
So when I was in high school, mm-hmm. I just did not care about my health.
Yeah.
And I did it like a bunch of repeated things. The last straw was I was lifting up a 10-gallon mm-hmm. In the training room. And
this is getting a little better now.
It is, yes, sir.
Yeah.
It like hit right. He's so mad that I'm calling him sir, isn't he? He's like, it's making me uncomfortable.
I was in the military and people would call me sir. I was like, I hate that.
I can't help it. I call people younger than me sir, so it makes them uncomfortable too.
This feels a little better, yeah.
But yeah, so a 10-gallon like hit right here and completely dislocated the ball from the joint. I tore like 3 or 4 ligaments, a couple of tendons. It was a great time.
That sounds so good.
it was wonderful.
This sounds like I would never want to do that.
This is a great time.
Let's have you go face down. So this, your lower vertebrae in through here. And you said you have trouble in that lower back a lot, right?
Yes, sir.
So I'm just gonna be completely honest with you, okay?
Mm-hmm.
So when somebody normally comes in and they're having a lot of weight, what ends up happening is that they start to hunch over, right? You hunch over because that's where most of that weight is. You don't have that much weight in the back per se. You have it more in the front.
Yeah.
So you start to develop this curvature in through here. And what actually is hurting part of that lower back is how that mid back is. So whenever you are exercising, whenever you're working out, whatever you're doing, you want to really focus on thoracic extension and actually building these muscles back so that way you can actually pull that back again.
Gotcha.
So I'm going to use this here. 2 years, huh? Since you got adjusted?
Yes, sir.
And you met Hanman how?
Through Beyond Built.
Through Beyond Built.
Good old Beyond Built.
Good old Beyond Built. So what makes Beyond Built different than other like fitness groups?
So it's really interesting. The tagline is more than just physical,
mm-hmm.
and it rings true to be that in every case.
like they don't just care. I say they, we don't just care about physical health. Like
yeah.
It's mind, body, and soul.
Mm-hmm.
It's just super important to know that like if one of us is not safe, chances are the rest of them aren't.
Right.
So you can work on your physical health all you want, but if you're not also working on your mental, emotional, and spiritual health,
mm-hmm.
then you're not going to make it that far.
Exactly. That's what health is, right? The aligning of mentally, physically, and spiritually, and socially, not just the absence of sickness or disease.
Yeah.
That is one thing that I do notice, looking at Chad's stories, and, you know, just seeing everything. Y'all seem like a big family.
It definitely is. We just got back from a retreat.
Yeah, from Arizona, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And it's really cool because it gives everyone a chance to get to know each other, but you also really get to know yourself.
Mm-hmm.
And like, we have a lot of really honest conversations and talk about things that are real and not just surface level. And I think that that's what separates it.
That's awesome. I love it. I think especially, I mean, you have a lot of insight being 24. I mean, when I was 24, you don't even ask me for advice.
That's how I feel sometimes.
Yeah. But you know, you have to, I mean, I think you already know it now, but you know, you're a leader, right? And you have to act like a leader because you've been through things that a lot of people haven't been. And when you can step into that and you own that, you can change so many more people's lives as well too.
Yeah, I don't necessarily think that that's what makes me a leader. I actually really don't like the word leader. Because I think for a long time, leader has an expectation attached to it.
Mm-hmm.
And so I think as long as you're doing what you think is best for you and you're honoring yourself and you're making yourself happy, then that's what sets you apart. It doesn't make you a leader. It just makes you authentic.
Mm-hmm.
And when you're authentic, that's what people gravitate towards.
I'm going to have to agree and disagree.
Okay.
But I think what you're saying is absolutely right. I think leaders are put into positions not by anybody else, but because they can relate to them.
Yeah.
Right?
I can understand that as well.
I think people are going to look up to you, and a lot of people do look up to you. And when people look up to you, I think there's also a responsibility that you have to have, not just for yourself, but for other people. Because what you go through in life, if you can use that to help benefit other people, that's what makes you a leader. And I think we're coming from the same place.
Definitely.
Right?
We definitely are.
What your reality of the term leader is,
mm-hmm.
right?
Yeah.
But I think we're coming from the same place in that sense. I'm going to check your glutes here. Does that hurt at all when I press here?
Definitely does. Ow!
Does it hurt more on the right side or the left side?
The left side.
Yeah, okay. So we're going to loosen up. So your glute medius, I mean, the fact that this one's also shorter, it's like it's protruding upwards,
mm-hmm.
but when we're looking on here and we're just doing, like this is also short. So we want to release this part. So I'm going to use my elbow, okay. which is the most comfortable thing in the world.
Ow!
Yeah. Actually, you know what? Sit up for me. I want to do something first. And then I want you to try and touch your toes, actually. Does that hurt at all when you do that?
Yeah, it hurts my hips.
Hurts your hips. So sit up straight, try and see how far you can go. Okay. Where do you feel that pain when you do that?
Right here.
Right through there, okay. Sit here again, and then I want you to look to the right. Does that hurt at all when you do that?
Mm-mm.
Look to the left. That looks tougher to do on this side. Look to the right again. So nose is right here, look to the left. Actually, it's about the same. Look to the right again. Do you feel tension when you do that?
Mm-mm.
Look to the left. So, well, the reason why I'm asking is because normally that nose should be like closer back
gotcha.
That way. Anatomically, like normally I'll take x-rays,
mm-hmm.
right? That way I can see like how the actual structure is in through here.
Yeah.
But since we can't, we're just gonna go based on ranges of motion and then other leg length checks and whatnot. So go back face down. So what I'm trying to do here is just loosen up, because whenever your hip is like this, it's tending to just hold a lot more tension in there. So we want to loosen this back. Does that hurt a little bit?
It does.
Yeah. Got serious, huh? I kicked off the sandals. watch out.
Getting comfy. Good.
So you've had the gastric sleeve,
mm-hmm.
right? What other surgeries have you had?
Just in general?
Yeah, I mean, just in general.
Yeah, so I had complete reconstructive surgery on my shoulder.
Mm-hmm.
I have had my gallbladder taken out, and I've had tons of tubes in my left ear. For mm-hmm. hearing, and my tonsils taken out.
Okay.
But I think that's about all the surgery. Yeah.
That's a good bit.
I say it as if it's only like one.
We're gonna start off adjusting in here. Now, when they adjusted you this way, did it hurt at all when he did it?
No, I don't think so.
Okay. We're just gonna go, I'm gonna just test the waters here first, okay? So I want you to look straight up in front of you first, but keep your chin down just like that, all right. So you can see, so this curve that just comes down this way, right, it's coming down too far, so we really want it to be like closer here and then have it dip in. But what I'm gonna do is just release this area first, right there, all right? Now what I'm also doing is trying to release down in through here. So I want you to take a deep breath in for me. Let the air out. Good, let your shoulders relax. Let everything go. There it goes. You feel that release all the way in there too?
I did, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Take the wind out of you a little bit?
Yeah, and that's why I was like laughing. I was like, oh, okay. Not expecting that.
Yeah. That's a pretty tough adjustment, honestly.
Mm-hmm. Why do you say it's a tough adjustment?
Because it hits like right onto that diaphragm and everything. So a lot of times whenever I do that adjustment, it like takes the wind out.
Gotcha.
Wind out of you, yeah.
Oh, the great angles. I'd love to see it.
So all you have to do is you're going to keep your teeth together. And the reason why is because I don't want you to bite your tongue.
Gotcha.
If you bite your tongue, you're not going to be able to eat today. And that's not going to be cool. I'm going to put my hands right here. So I want you to let me have full control of your neck. And I want you to try and relax those shoulders. You feel that in the mid back a little bit there?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Jesus Christ. I was not expecting that. Slightly scared for my life. It's fine. I'm good. I'm chilling.
You're good?
Yeah.
How far down did you feel it?
All, my entire spine.
Your entire spine?
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah.
That's good. The reason why we did that is because there's a lot of compression, right? When you're like this, there's a lot of compression. And sometimes whenever I'm pressing into it, it's going to be a lot tougher. So gotcha. I wanted to do this. Now we're going to go in this way. And you're going to turn here. So now, right into that middle spot. Good. Let your shoulders roll over my hands. That's great. You can feel that moving already. Deep breath in. Let the air out. Good. Let the shoulders drop down. Let it fold in more. More. Let the knees relax. There it goes.
That was very nice. I think my arms are stuck. That was very nice.
That was a great release.
It feels so much better already.
That's good.
Yeah.
How's that lower spot? That lower back?
That feels a lot better, because when I set up right before, like, there's a lot of tension, so it feels a lot better.
Good, good. Go back down. Take a deep breath in, let it out. This is going to take the breath out of you a little bit more. Good. Okay. Good.
Sit up for me. Face that way. You get headaches, migraines, anything like that?
Mm-mm. No. Not that I can think of.
Man, if you thought you lost your life after that,
please. The neck one? I'm not ready.
This is the best one.
I'm not ready for the neck one.
If you think. Now it's a threat.
All right, didn't realize I was dying twice today.
And he's standing you might do like the mocha, so you know you're
dying. I'm nervous.
You're going to be totally fine. I've done this like twice.
Oh, okay. That's comfortable.
I've done this twice. I'm just kidding. Once.
No, this is not how I like to be hugged.
So I'm just going to let your shoulder relax there, all right? Let your shoulders drop. I know it's a little scary. Anytime somebody has you in a headlock like this, it's kind of weird. But we're going to let your head just kind of drop down a little bit more. Ponman, trust me. You got to trust me too.
Jesus Christ. Oh, that one hurt. Definitely saw my life flash before my eyes. Mike's like crying over there. Damn. All right.
We'll just let it just relax for a minute.
Not only am I in shock, but I am dead on the inside now. Well, it's a good thing you're good at your job.
Yeah, because you're still alive. How's it feel?
It feels good. I feel like it tightened up right here.
Mm-hmm.
But other than that, it feels really good.
It's okay. We're going to go to the other side.
I bet you are. I'm nervous.
I promise you're going to be fine. But there is a lot of tension on that top part there. Loosen this one down.
Good. Ow. Mike is. Look at Mike.
Oh my god, dude.
That's. I think he felt it more than I did. That felt good. That felt really good.
Crazy at first.
Yeah, it's intense.
Yeah, it's definitely not conventional, but.
I think the thing that got me is when you had to stand on the table to do it, that's where I was like, I'm in trouble. I'm concerned.
I might die, but yeah. It's fine.
Hanman, what did you get me into?
So I want you to loosen. Relax that foot. That's it. Great.
I didn't even feel the pop. Like, that's how fast it was.
I felt it. We're gonna drop this off. Just like kids. There he goes.
Love that. Felt good. That one.
Yeah?
Yep. Felt that one.
Let's have you lay on your side.
So, I'm gonna be, like, dropping in here. Yeah. Alright, if I drop, you're okay?
Yeah.
So, I want you to keep your head turned that way. And keep this loosened. And what you're gonna do is just relax this part right there. There he goes. Small one. That's good though.
Weird.
I'm just gonna let that go. Good. Beautiful. Now, lay on your back. I'm gonna use this on you.
I'm concerned. Is that the...
It's a watch guard.
Yep. I thought I was gonna die before.
love this. So my parents will be here this week. Just tell them that I love them. And this and Dr. Tubio, the bill.
You did this all in the focus too.
I'm concerned.
You'll be fine. Do you feel that in your mid back there?
I do.
Okay, take another deep breath. Loosen up the grip on your hands. And exhale. Do you feel that in the mid back still?
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Oh God, bless America. I'm trying so hard not to cuss on your channel now. I don't think I can feel my toes.
Stay there.
That was good. Yeah.
It sucks at first. It does.
Yep, that was good.
What are you feeling right now?
My mid back is kind of tightening up, and definitely went numb in my toes for a minute. But other than that, I feel great.
How do the toes feel right now?
They're good. But other than that, I feel good. 10 out of 10, recommend. If you want to die. It feels good though.
That feels good now, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the trip. You look like you're sitting up straighter too.
It feels a lot straighter.
Look straight now, look to the right. Good. How does that feel?
It feels good.
Look to the left. That's pretty good. Stand up and then move forward. Let's try and touch your toes. Good. How's it feeling in your lower back?
Feels good.
Yeah?
Yeah.
How's the pain?
There's still a little bit there on like the left side, but it feels a lot better.
Good.
Yeah.
How was your first experience? I know you probably died a few times, but...
Honestly, I feel really good. Like, I very much needed that. Because I feel like my performance in the gym has been suffering because I've had like lat tightness or like my lower back. So I'll go to do like squats and like deadlifts, or I'll go to do like lat pull downs, and I feel like I'm limited because my range of motion isn't there.
Yep.
And so now I just feel like looser.
Yeah. You feel like I get adjusted before I go to the gym too, because it helps me activate some of the muscles that aren't activating, just because the muscles are connected to the spine.
Yeah.
Right. And when there's no extension, there's no motion, you can't get that full contraction that you really want sometimes.
Mm-hmm.
Cool.
Yeah, I definitely feel good.
Sorry to give you some life scares.
Oh, no, it's okay. I probably deserved it.
No.
After the day that I've had, yes.
Well, I appreciate you telling your story.
Honestly. I appreciate you. Thank you for doing this. Thank you, Hanman, for being a bro and someone that I can't stand sometimes.
Yeah.
This was cool. I appreciate it.
Yeah, I appreciate you. I know he didn't tell you what you're getting into.
No, he literally was like, be free at 7:30. And I was like, that's concerning.
Well, I hope we helped you out today.
Definitely. Well, I'm definitely going to get you some stuff. So we actually own a brand, and I'd love to get you some shirts and stuff if you're down for it.
That'd be great. Well, I appreciate you.
Thank you.
Let's talk it out. Awesome.
I appreciate that.
Yeah, I appreciate you too. Give them the handles on if they want to follow you and everything. So.
Okay, I gotta plug myself. So on Instagram, you can find me at lana.lifts. I recently just started a podcast called Own It With Lana. It's on Apple and Spotify, and the brand that we run is called Cultured Vibes. You can find us @_culturedvibes on Instagram.
Cool. Follow her. It's awesome. I love what you're trying to do. I love the purpose behind it.
Thank you.
And that's really what I connect to more than anything with anybody else.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
Awesome. Thank you, Hanman.
Thanks, Hanman.
For setting this up.